I think we're all looking forward to that Leaf-Bruins series in the East. That has got a chance to be a tremendous seven-gamer. Two excellent teams, well over 100 points. Lou Lamoriello knows his deal around the Stanley Cup. One of three of them with the Devils, runs the Leafs right now, and he says hello. Lou, nice to talk. How are you today, pal, okay?
Very well, Chris, and how are you doing?
I'm doing well, Lou. It's good to have you aboard this Leaf team. Give me the biggest difference. Is it experience, Lou? What's the biggest difference going into this postseason series against the Bruins compared to last year against the Capitals? What do you see?
Well, I think experience certainly is number one, and also maturity. I think that that comes along with experience when you have young players. And the addition of a couple of veterans who know what it takes to win to help the young players that we have along.
Right, and obviously last year, a very good series against the Capitals. That series could have gone either way. Enough experience on a young team and a very good regular season. Tough division, but you were the third best team, no question about it. You could have been a little higher than that. You had to be very happy with the consistency there, Lou, of the Maple Leaf regular season from start to finish. How about that for a sec?
Yes, Chris. Our coaching staff just did a tremendous job. In my opinion, the best in the National Hockey League, with staying with it each and every night in the development of the young players and having, as you said, the consistency throughout the year. But right now we're going into a new season, and it's a new season for every team. And that's the way we have to approach it.
And the Bruins are going to be tough. This is a hard matchup. You probably thought for a long time, Lou, you might get Tampa into the Bruins lost a game on Sunday. How surprised were you that it's the Bruins in the first round instead of the Lightning in the first round? Give me some thoughts there.
Well, I don't think either one would have been a surprise. They're two of the best teams in the National Hockey League. And when you're coming down to a separation of, a couple of points when you have games left, anything can happen, and that's exactly what transpired. It came right down to the last day. But you're right. The Bruins are an excellent hockey team. They've consistently been that way. And this should be an excellent series.
Oh, I really should be looking forward to it. All right, Matthews here. What's he learned, Lou? He's obviously a tremendous player. He's going to draw their toughest line. Give me a little rundown on Austin Matthews in this series. What do you see?
Well, he without question is one of the better players in the National Hockey League at his age. He wants to be good. He works at it. And so that this series to him is very important. It's been a year where he's had a couple of injuries, and yet he still had an exceptional year. So, he's very important to our team, but we're very fortunate to have a lot of young players who are very important to our team, as I said earlier, also veterans. So this is a team. This isn't about one player. This is the type of group that you like to have. They're dependent upon each other. They want to have success for each other, and they root for each other. Austin, no different.
You've been in that third spot for a while now. It looked to be that you were going to be playing the second place team for a good 10, 12 games late in the year. So I don't want to say you got stagnant, but you kind of were secure, not going up, maybe not going down. Give me your thoughts about that, getting ready for this best of seven series here. What do you see?
Well, I don't think it's any different than when, you've had a outstanding year or a good year and you're in the playoffs, several weeks before the playoffs start. You're always going to have a little bit of a hiccup or where you can't, sort of get out. But our coaches, as I said, did a great job to keep everybody focused, because it's very important to be as sharp as you possibly can. But that's in the past right now. Now we have to get ready, for this first game.
This is going to be a tremendous series. Physical, too. These two teams, and 2 years, whatever it was, 3-4 years ago, Leafs should have won this series. They had the Bruins dead. Nobody cares about that right now. But you love to see an original six matchup in round one, Lou. Historically, it's fun. Thoughts on that for a second. What can you tell me there?
Without question. I think that the rivalries that the original six have, I never realized it was to the extent it is until I came to Toronto. And you visit these original six series and you see the rivalries and you see the reciprocal rivalries when you even play in your own building, what it is to play Montreal, what it is to play Detroit and Boston and so forth. So there's no question about it. and it should be extremely exciting.
Bruins are pretty flexible. They can do anything they want. So what is the key in your, they can play physical, they want to go up and down, defense, good goalie. What's your take here? What do the Leafs have to do in your eyes? They got to make things happen, stay out of the penalty box, win a standout. What's the key for the Leafs in this series, Lou, for you to win it? What do you see?
Well, what we have to do is stay within who we are, not allow to get distracted in any way whatsoever, be dependent upon each other, and just do what we do best is individually and collectively allow the end result to take care of itself.
Good point about the distraction. The Bruins will try to, you know, rile you up a little bit. You got to make sure you don't retaliate with Marchand and people like that, correct?
Well, I think that these are excellent players that they have. We played against them enough throughout the season. Right now, I don't think that'll be a concern as far as the distraction, but we have to make sure that we don't allow it to be.
All right, Anderson and Nets, you got good confidence in him. You know something about goalies. You had Brodeur all those years. You know, you like to go up and down a little bit, so Anderson's going to have to make some big saves. Give me your thoughts on your goalkeeper in this series, Lou. Thoughts there?
Well, without question, Freddie has had an outstanding year for us. He broke the franchise record here for wins in a season. And he's played outstanding since he's got here. But Boston also has an outstanding goaltender in every series in the playoffs. No different, Chris, than pitching, and no different in football or quarterback. You know how important they are. They have to rise to the occasion, and they are the key player in every series.
Absolutely right. They got to steal your game. Lou, we're looking forward to it. Bruins and Leafs should be a great seven-gamer. Thanks. Keep up the good work. Thanks for a few minutes here today. We appreciate it.
No, you're welcome, Chris. Always a pleasure, and I'm glad to see everything's going well.
Lou Lamoriello, one of the best general managers in the sport. Conversations with him. We continue Leafs and Bruins. That series begins, by the way, tomorrow night in Boston. They'll play Thursday and Saturday night at the TD Bank North. Lots to still do. Hockey Show 2018 continuing right after that.